25th of March to May 31st, 2020, India was in their first lockdown due to coronavirus. I don't know how many people died because of coronavirus, but 200 migrant workers were killed due to road accidents and hunger. June 2019, farmers were protesting against a road project, a 8-lane road project from Salem to Chennai, because of the fear of land acquisition. In 2018, a survey revealed that 97,000 people are being killed due to road accidents. I don't know whether all the category of people are getting benefits because of these roads, but a country's development and growth mainly depends upon roads, especially highways. And a country like India will become a developed nation mainly because of its infrastructural development. Forget about these positives and negatives. Let us look back at our road development history of India.
வரலாறு மிக முக்கியம் அமைச்சரே.
இந்தியா ஹாஸ் த செகண்ட் லார்ஜஸ்ட் ரோட் நெட்வொர்க் இன் த வேர்ல்ட், ஸ்பேனிங் ஓவர் எ டிஸ்டன்ஸ் ஆஃப் 5.89 million kilometers. And overall, this road network alone transports 65% of the goods traffic and 90% of the passenger traffic. But exactly, we don't know when was the starting point of this road construction. However, with the evidences we have and the historical proof, the first roads were found in 2800 BC. During the excavations from Indus Valley Civilization in the ancient cities of Mohenjo-daro and Harappa, there were evidences of planned roads and streets in India during 2800 BC. After them, Mauryan kings also built very good roads. There are ancient books like Arthashastra, which was written by Kautilya, who was a great administrator in Mauryan time. The book contained rules and regulations for maintaining the traffic, depth of road, and even punishments for obstructing the traffic. Next to them, it was Mughal emperors who improved the roads in India. Mughal emperors built roads linking northwestern and eastern areas through Gangetic Plain. Another good example was Grand Trunk Road, one of the Asia's oldest major road. It was rebuilt by many emperors and kings like Mauryans, Mughals, Sir Emperors, and then British managed to reconstruct it. Initially, British came in the form of East India Company during the Mughal India. Later, the East India Company captured the entire Indian subcontinent and started ruling it. They were very keen in developing our Indian infrastructure. Then only they can drain our wealth and support their home country. In 1830, they started a metalled road construction. They even reconstructed our Grand Trunk Road. And later, they also started laying roads from Pune to Bombay and Bombay to Agra and even Bombay to Madras. And they are the responsible for our today's PWD, that is Public Work Department, was started in 1834 by Lord Dalhousie. After that, railways become very popular. So they started laying railway lines across our country. In that period, road construction was given less importance. Then once again, after the First World War, there was a rapid growth in motor vehicles, which made the necessity for a better roads. For overcoming this problem, Indian government appointed a committee called Road Development Committee with Mr. M.R. Jayakar as a chairman in 1927. Later, this committee was turned out to be Jayakar Committee. They examined the conditions of the road at the time and submitted their report in 1928. The recommendations given by the committee are: State government do not have the capacity to develop the roads and maintain it. Therefore, central government should take care of the road development in the country as a national interest. And the second recommendation was an extra tax should be levied on petrol and diesel from the users so that this fund will be used for developing the roads across the country. And this fund is known to be Central Road Fund. And the third recommendation was a semi-official body should be created in order to collect ideas and technical knowledge all over the country, which will act as an advisory committee for roads. Was a research organization should be established in order to conduct research and discover innovative methods related to road development in India. Most of the recommendations given by the Jayakar committee was accepted and implemented by the government. In 1929, Central Road Fund was created. This was created in order to collect petrol and diesel tax from the users. In 1934, Indian Road Congress was formed for giving advice on road developments. In 1950, Central Road Research Institute was formed in order to conduct research regarding roads. Finally, Jayakar Committee gave an idea of long-term planning program for a period of 20 years. And this planning program was later known to be as famous 20-year road plan. According to the long-term road development plan, in 1943, Nagpur Road Congress was formed and the first 20-year road development program was finalized between 1943 to 1963. Roads were divided into four categories: national highways, state highways, district roads, and village roads. The committee planned to construct 2 lakh kilometers of roads within 20 years. The main objective of this road plan was the road length should be increased to give a road density of 16 kilometers per 100 square kilometer. After that, in 1961, Bombay Road Congress happened, and this leads to the second 20-year road plan from 1961 to 1981. Now the target road length was 10 lakh kilometers. The road density target is 32 kilometers per 100 square kilometers. Additionally, 1600 kilometer expressways was also included in the plan. And finally, in the history of road development, Lucknow Road Congress plays a major part, since it was the reason for the development of third 20-year road plan. The main aim of this plan is to connect all the villages in India, and also every part of the country should be within 50 kilometers from the national highways. Now the target length was from 10 lakhs to 12 lakhs kilometers across the country, and the road density target is 82 kilometers per every 100 square kilometer.
நல்லா இருக்கு.
நல்லா இருக்கியா?
நல்லா இருக்கு.
நல்லா தானே இருக்கியா?
அட நல்லா இருக்கு.